Trying to get her money, she was 19. Moving to Miami was a life's dream. They told her she could end up on a white screen. She liked it, she thought she was like me. Stacy got the brib
and a brand new bag. And we live, baby.
What were you saying?
Did he ever figure out how to make the 360 degree video longer?
Oh yeah, I thought that he was doing that just because that's like the max length it could be.
But it's like, how can you like stretch that out, like enlarge it? Because I mean, it is a camera. Like, do you need like more space? Like, what the fuck is it?
Yeah, I don't know, man. So I got the crop mop. The crop cleanser, the foot duster, some cologne, then the plow 2.0 sitting in front of me, man.
Shout out.
This shit's crazy, man. So Shout out manscaped.com.
Yeah, so I think that's everything that he got.
And that was, how much did he drop, like 100 on that thing?
Yeah, I think that's what he said.
Jesus, man. Well,
that boy better last for a lifetime.
Yeah. Well, welcome back to the podcast, man. I feel like I should start doing some sort of like intro shit, like welcome back, you know, keep scrolling. Some sort of tagline.
Yeah, subscribe.
Yeah.
We're on Twitter, Instagram.
Follow us on all platforms. We live.
Hey, yeah. So how was Sedona?
Yeah. I mean, so, how do I say it? Sedona's cool, you know. I don't necessarily think I would go, you know. Well, I mean, the only time we went even was because Steph was from Iowa, and you never been there either. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, other than that, I feel like once you go, it's kind of like Vegas to me. You know, once you go once, it's enough. Or the Grand Canyon, you know. It's cool to take people up there because it's some shit they've never seen before, especially cats from Ohio. Yeah, so shout out.
I think it'd be interesting to just do, like, each time go up there and do something different.
Yeah.
Like, say one time you go up there and you pick a place and you go camp. Mm-hmm. Next time you pick a place and you, like, say you do pick a hiking trail. Or next time you go, you go whitewater rafting or some shit like that. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
That'd be interesting, but like if to go up there and then like to go see the same spot every single time, like, mm-hmm. Yeah, this is beautiful.
I don't know. It's just hard. And like, somebody here?
I think Al ran to the door.
I don't know, man. It's just hard because you drive there, then you get to the main street and shit. You see all the craziness, like then you can just park and just walk around, and then after that it's kind of just like there's really nothing, mm-hmm. nothing to do unless you're trying to hike or some shit. But I mean, you make a good point. Kind of go up there, try to do something different every time. But I don't know. I'd rather go to like another city or some shit. You know.
Yeah, that's true. I'm just saying, like, if it's just one of those things where it's like you continue to use that as a getaway. You know how people, you know, go to Flagstaff and shit like that. Like, oh, it's cooler. I'm going to go up there. So say shit, you do go up there, then you just do something different. But it just depends on, like, if you're going with, like, a different group or the same group. Because sometimes, you know, some motherfuckers want to go to the same spot. Man, I want to go see the same
right,
spot.
Right, bro.
Tired of that spot, man.
It's kind of like you know how people have them same like restaurants or bars and shit that they go to every weekend, time. Every day or whatever. It's kind of the same concept to me. I could never really
understand that.
Yeah. And then it's just like, oh, you see the same people, and it's like, no shit, you see the same people because you fucking do the same shit every single day.
Yeah, that's the same crowd every single time, and that's what happens. Like, you know, a lot of people talk about, like, say, you know, Scottsdale and people that's in Scottsdale. You know, people say stuff about them all the time, but then shit, where do you find them in Scottsdale?
Mm-hmm. Like, right. So I mean, it's the same thing. Yeah. So you're bitching about these people, but then you're putting yourself in that situation to be around those people. So who's really the issue here? You know,
it's true.
And it's just, I don't know, man. I mean, Steph said it best. People are always going to find something to bitch or complain about, you know. Like, out here, it's over the summer, it's nice as fuck, but it's 110 degrees. Everybody's bitching about how hot it is and all that shit, so I don't know. But, I don't know what made me think of this. Shout out to fucking Brussels, man. on the insights or whatever when I was looking for some reason. I don't know if it's because I said Brussels and it shit got like tracked, but I'm just gonna keep saying fucking Brussels this whole fucking episode to get these fucking plays going. You know what I'm saying? Well, I don't know if it's bots. Oh, I don't know what the fuck it is.
But shout out Brussels.
Man. I don't even know why the fuck I was talking about Brussels the last time. But when I was looking on SoundCloud and shit, Brussels was playing like 50. And then there was another country in Belgium too. I can't remember. I just remember the flag and shit. But
hey, yeah, shout out Brussels.
Yeah, anyway, man, what you think about the draft? Is the draft over? Is it over for the day, or what's going on with that?
Honestly, I didn't really pay attention to it. I just caught up with a couple of the picks and saw like the first 10 or whatever.
Yeah, who went number one? Taco?
Andrew, Edwards. He went to Georgia. Hey, dude, nice.
Yeah.
Dude, nice. I ain't gonna lie.
But, I don't know, man.
But Timberwolves, I always want to get the number one pick, but they don't do shit with them.
But I mean, who was it? It was the Cavs. Was the same way for a while too.
Yeah, that is true.
And Browns, you know.
Hey, LeBron did that on purpose.
What?
That's why he left, just so they can get a couple of number ones. So
let's take it back. What do you think about that whole situation? Like when he left for Miami. What was your ten? What's Ron's 10-year-old opinion on that?
I was like, shit, I'm like 20.
Yeah.
Damn, I'm old as fuck. But honestly, like, I felt like
happy belated birthday too.
Appreciate that.
I don't know if we said it last time, but
I don't know if we did.
I don't even know.
But yeah, like I think it was a. It was a chess move, I believe. I believe that he went to Miami so that they can get something, because with him being there, you're going to always be winning. You're not going to be able to get draft picks. Now one of the things you got to do is you got to try to make cap space to get people. He's going to take some of the pay cut, you know what I mean? Yeah. But not that much. And then for like the Cavaliers to be such a I feel like they're in a smaller market than some teams. It's a little bit harder to get that revenue to come in for those other players, especially if you're paying him however much a year.
Top dollar.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I remember it so vividly that I was like, and just like how pissed I was. It wasn't even. I'm off the charts, man. My bad.
He said I'm off the charts.
It wasn't even really just. Like what he did, like that's fine by me, but just more so just how, you know, like what was there, like a TV show called The Decision, and it was this whole like hour like debacle fucking spectacle on this one dude changing basketball teams, you know what I mean? And I was just like, I remember him announcing, and I'm like, everybody already knew.
Yeah,
you know, you know, ESPN's like ticker at the bottom. It was the same year Melo changed team. I think that was the year he went to the Knicks or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember. It's been a while, but because I'm pretty sure he was with the Nuggets at first, right?
Yeah, that was his first team.
But anyway, so this dude announces where the fuck he's going. The whole world is watching, because I guess he's God or something. But underneath, like on ESPN's ticker, it says Carmelo announces he's leaving for the Knicks, and I was just like, "Yo, like, was it really? Did you have to do like the show, just bringing all this fucking?"
That's what I'm saying. Like, I with LeBron, like I feel like everything with him is like some sort of chess move, because he is finding a way to do a lot of things, and so like I say if he did that and then like. Whatever proceeds were given to a certain foundation, You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that'd be cool. Like, I feel like that's something that, like, he'd do. Like, people would be, like, hating him for. And that's why I feel like after that, everybody hated him. That's why
I went to Miami. But I feel like everybody had the right to. You know what I'm saying? Especially as a Cleveland fan. And you know how all them fans are and shit, bro. You, like, nobody even knows Cleveland. And then this dude announces that he's leaving to go somewhere else. I was just like, man, that shit was fucking crazy. I did that shit. I burned all his shit, bro. I had shirts. I never had the jersey, but I burned his shoes. I didn't wear his shoes no more. I said, fuck that motherfucker, man.
I was
a part of that madness, man.
You were on ESPN. You were one of the little clips.
Yeah.
Fuck him.
Still, man, I'm just like,
oh man. But the thing about it is, it's like I knew he was gonna go back.
Mm.
He left Cleveland and went to Miami, and Cleveland still didn't have a championship.
Yeah,
I knew before he retired or whenever he retired, he was gonna bring a ship to Cleveland.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Well, and then they still couldn't keep him.
Yeah,
it's not even on him then, and a lot of people think that I feel like even that decision was somewhat of the same,
mm-hmm.
because it's like, okay, well, you still can't give me what I want. Like, I mean, like, we need
some teammates.
You know what I mean? Like, we need some teammates to help me out. It's kind of the same shit with
the Last Dance.
Yeah,
and yeah, just how the I guess you would say the front office kind of fucked everything up.
Oh yeah, it dismantled him. Like, it just tore him apart.
At the end of the day, man, it's a business, and I feel like people tend to forget that, you know.
Yeah, it definitely is a business. So that's why even now, like, look at James Harden. He's like, he's like, I don't want the extension or something like that. He was like, I want to continue with the trade to the Nets.
Oh, he wants out.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
So it's like, now you got him. Going to the Nets with Durant, Irving, Kyrie Irving.
I don't know, man. I don't see another like time period or like draft class like Melo, like.
Oh, the 03 class?
Yeah, all of them.
Yeah, that's one of the best classes.
I feel like that's. I don't think there's been another time remotely close to that.
I think 84.
Maybe. Yeah, I was going to say maybe Magic and Bird or some shit.
No, they were before that.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, I think they were.
Oh, you saying 84 like Jordan?
Jordan. Because I think that that class came out with like John Stockton and
The Mailman?
I think so. Yeah, Mailman.
Yo, didn't he like rape somebody or something? Didn't he?
I think it was something like that. Let me look.
So knowing that, like, what's your opinion on the mailman after that? Like, after you find out he raped somebody, and then you realize that his nickname is the mailman. What's your opinion on that? That's some fucked up shit, kind of. That's low key pretty fucked up.
And that'd be fucked up, like, as far as, like, the people that don't know him. And then, like, people are also, like, say right now, like, we're talking about the mailman. And so it's like, we're talking about the mailman. People probably watch this or listen to this and be like, hey, we need to see who the hell he is.
Right,
look
right.
Like, mailman, great. Whoa, hold on.
Then you just go down a fucking, fucking rabbit hole, yeah. Jesus.
Oh, man. I think it was.
I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure he did.
Hold on.
I can't remember how I even found that out. Oh shit! Let's
see. Oh, I guess he escaped it.
I think it was statutory,
right?
I don't know the classification. So what's statutory mean? I don't know the classifications of rape.
statutory would be like she was too young, and it was like say it's consenting, but it was just
it's wrong. Yeah.
So he like he was 20 and she was 13. Mm-hmm.
So they were I mean, the Clintons were probably still on Epstein's island at that time.
Probably. I wonder when did he get that? When did he get the island? I never finished it.
We haven't heard much about Maxwell.
Oh no, you're not. You're not gonna hear.
Yeah, why do you think that is?
Man, it's crazy though, because it's like I was watching something on Snapchat, and it's just talking about how. And this is just, I feel like it's just stupid. Like, you got people out here that, like, you know how somebody is going to react, you know, mm-hmm. and you know their mannerism, stuff like that. So it's like, you know, if I talk to a person every day, like, say, like, your parents, and you know, they know you coming home every day, stuff like that. And then you don't come home one night and shit like that, they don't hear from you, mm-hmm. can't get in contact. And then say she's like, man, something fell off. I need to go to police. I need to report this. And then you go to report it. And then what happened? They'd be like, oh, well, he probably just ran off on his own. Or like, what the, what?
Protect and serve, baby.
But then it's like, all right. Then a couple weeks later, month later, or however, you find the body in a park or some shit like that. Uh-huh. And you're like, oh, well, we... Like, you could have did something. Like, the first couple hours, they always talk about, is the most critical, right?
And then the first couple hours, nobody's doing shit.
Thank you.
Yeah. So out of all the conspiracy theories and shit, which one to you, I guess, reigns, like, the most true?
Oh, man. I mean, you got
to... I just thought about this.
I mean, you got to... I mean, like, which conspiracy?
Well, right? I mean, obviously, like, Epstein's a hot topic right now. No, everybody knows he didn't fucking... Mm-hmm. What did they say? He killed himself or something? Or
hung himself?
Yeah.
I mean, I just feel like it's a lot of power that comes out of that.
Not that he didn't like kill himself, but like there's more. There's so much more to why, who, and how. You know what I'm saying? For that one. That's very obvious. That's very obvious.
And for that, it's crazy because that's one of those. I mean, I feel like a lot of them are still fresh or whatever, mm-hmm. but I feel like a lot of them kind of, in a sense, probably will, at some point, like collide or coincide. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like,
well, what do we got? The 9/11, you got Bin Laden, fucking aliens, fucking, I can't really think of no more, but out of any of them that you can think of, which one, I guess, do you think has the highest probability of being, minus Epstein, of being...
Out of true. All of them. Mm-hmm. That's a lot though. Like,
and then you can even throw the Rona in there, and the money situation and shit.
How about I say this? Or how about I ask you this?
Can I switch it real quick? That's a nice shirt, by the way.
Oh yeah. I had borrowed it from my friend. He had left it. So I was like, shit, I'm going to wear this motherfucker.
Hell yeah.
But now I forgot my fucking question.
You were going to ask me a question about... Well, I was asking you about conspiracy theories. Which one do you think is the...
I was going to ask you, though. I was going to be like, okay, what if the whole beginning is, like, from the start of the everything was the conspiracy?
So you're saying that, like, we're a part of the conspiracy?
Yeah, I feel like we are.
Since,
like,
the beginning of time?
From the beginning? I'm talking about, like, U.S. Like, from the beginning of that motherfucker coming over here to get this damn land. It's just all it's been is just conspiracy since then. Like, you had a fucking civil war because motherfucker was like, you the North and I'm the South. We going to slave down here. Yeah. Y'all don't.
I'm black, you're white.
You know what I mean? Like, now we're, like, all together, but at the same time, we go to vote this year, and then what happens? It's still 50-50.
The whole voting thing literally blows my mind, because it's like, yo, the whole world, not just us, the whole world is bitching about this dude. Yeah, is this close? Why are you guys lying? if
why are you
yeah,
lying?
Bro, like if you support this dude, say it. Why are you like going behind like a counter and checking a box and then saying going out and saying nah, fuck him.
Yeah, that
fuck
is
out of here, bro.
Yeah, there's so many people that are like that.
If all that hate was true, there's no chance it would have been this close or with this outcome. You know what I'm saying? That shit is crazy. But go on.
But that's what I was saying though. Like that's why I was like, it's all based off of people that, you know, say like grown up with the, you know, the red side. They're like, oh, I'm red. They probably don't know nothing about this. You know what's going on? But they're like, I'm red. Yeah,
how it that's started? Just their vote, why? Just look.
So in all actuality, it's just like, you know, I feel like it's just like playing favorites in a sense. You know, you pick all your friends when you're at, you know, when you're at reset or when you're at gym, because you want that bomb ass team. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, so it's like it's, stack them.
That's all it's doing is just stacking them. That's why I was telling you, like, you got fucking Trailer Park, like people like in the hollers of like West Virginia and shit like that, and then like you're Republican, you ain't got no money, nothing like that. Like, and then like you are just like what they say is bad about black people being in the projects. It's just the same thing. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's just your version of the projects.
Right.
Shit's crazy. But out of all the conspiracies, man, like I feel like just dealing with the government, I think there's a lot of information that we are misled on, and so it's up to us to
the blind leading the blind.
Basically. We just need to, and that's one of the crazy things. Like you always hear about, like, say the people that want to finally come out and say something, end up dead or something like that. They can't talk or get the information out. I mean, and for something to be so big, especially to be, you know, like the United States, you know, Brittany Kaiser, what she say? She said, "I got two of the most powerful governments in the world looking for me."
Right, right. So I was watching something. They were saying Putin has a fucking YouTube channel or something. It's one of the biggest like watched YouTube channels in Russia.
I don't know how true that is. Shout out Putin.
This dude's killing it on YouTube.
Yeah, look, shout out Putin. He getting his views up. Shit.
I was watching something too. I think they were playing hockey or soccer or something, and they just like let him score because everybody's just so fucking like terrified of this dude.
Skip that. I'll be over there slide tackling his ass. Yeah. Foul. Skip that. That's how we play.
But imagine that doing that, then you just wake up dead. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I ain't waking up. Shit. You ain't coming back from that.
Yeah, that's crazy.
You little fucker.
So
you fuck with my goal.
out of all the government conspiracies, which then which would you say?
I don't know. I guess for
shout out Brussels,
in Belgium, U.S. also.
Yeah, that's a given.
Yeah, but starting shout out you ugly motherfucker.
San Francisco for some reason.
I didn't even look that far.
Yeah.
Government. I feel like the 2001 was a big one.
Oh, so 9/11?
Yeah, I feel like 9/11 is a big
one. Yeah, so what about 9/11?
Just everything that transpired, especially like with, you know, the building actually like getting a plane ran into it and then burning and falling in like minutes.
So how about this? What if all of that doesn't really check out? What do you say when somebody claims to have like been in one of those said buildings, yada yada, and they like tell their story on experience in that day? How do you feel about that?
I mean, honestly, like I feel like that'd be that's That'd be, I feel like that'd be insane as far as like trying to have empathy for them for everything that happened. But at the same time, like, mm-hmm. you know, for them, they didn't know that, you know, it's, they were behind like whatever was going on.
It's just kind of wrong place, wrong time.
Yeah, basically. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And then it's like there's, I mean, I feel like there's a lot of things where it's like some shit does line up, you know, like how people can make shit line up. But there's like so many different things on like people not making the plane, or a lot of people that didn't make the to work that day inside of the building. You know what I mean? That weren't even there for some reason or whatever. You know what I mean? Like, we would never know.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Like, the whole building's gone. There's so many people. A lot of people died. You know what I mean? Like,
one of the conspiracies that stands out to me is the fucking moon. like going to the moon and shit. And then I was thinking, I was like, yo, imagine being, cause did he die? The cat who supposedly went to the moon?
Who, fucking Armstrong?
Yeah, Armstrong. Shout out Lance. Shout out Brussels. But shout out Lance. imagine living your whole life. You do this amazing thing, and then everybody like you come into contact with is like just doubting that it even fucking happened. but like that's the only reason anybody even knows your fucking name. I was just thinking, I was like, yo, I couldn't imagine that. You had to have gotten some sort of, you know, write off, payoff, whatever you want to say.
He just
keep pushing this.
This fantasy.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot to keep up with. At a certain point,
your whole life is a fucking fluke, man.
Like, your whole life, you still telling a lie, and then like at a certain point, you just don't sit there.
It all seems real at some point. Yeah, that's crazy.
Man.
Yeah, I was just thinking about that the other day. I was like, man, because somebody was saying something about the flag waving and shit, and I was like, honestly, I don't even think fuck all that. I don't really look too far into it, but I don't even think it ever happened, regardless of all the.
So we haven't been back.
The facts.
We haven't been back since.
Yeah, that's the end of my like rant right there. You know what I'm saying? Why would we do all this to go somewhere,
and then not go back?
Like make it a big thing that we went there, and then when's the last time? You know what? Like that shit. To me, it doesn't make no sense. I that's fucking crazy. Fucking crazy, man. Is anything else going on in the news that you know of?
In the news, I don't know. I don't think Trump's gonna get out of office.
you gonna hold his spot down? I seen that he was trying to do like what is it called, a recount in Wisconsin or some shit. Imagine that too, man.
But he still lost.
Yeah.
Either way, but
I think
that show, My Cartoon President.
Oh, is it on FX?
Is it on Showtime?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I think you're right.
I think it might be on Showtime.
I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's on Showtime. Yeah, but yeah, that shit be having me hollering. I only watched a couple episodes.
That shit I was watching the other day, yesterday. I was like, "What the fuck is?"
What was he watching?
It was like some cartoon shit. The shit that he got.
Sailor Moon.
Yeah.
Look, I would think of the damn name of the damn game I was talking about.
What game?
From yesterday.
What game?
Kingdom Hearts.
I don't know what that is. Fill me in, man.
Yeah, that's what that reminded me of.
Oh, the drawing. Mm-hmm. Were you big into that? Like Pokemon and fucking...
I had
what was the other one? Dragon Ball Z?
Dragon Ball Z, not as much, but I did watch a lot of it.
Yeah. Miss those days, man. Just playing Game Boy, just fucking shit up. Trying to catch them all.
Yeah, they got them... They ended up coming out with Pokemon Go. You got it on your phone now.
Did you get big into that?
I did it for a little bit, but shit, that was just to get out and walk.
Yeah, I remember when it blew up, just going over to like Tempe Town Lake and shit.
And I see these people.
It just, yeah, everybody's just fucking.
All I did was I had mine and I just put it in my pocket and like when it vibrated I just like got you.
Bloop bloop.
Got you, man. Gotcha.
I don't know, man.
Uh oh. Let's go touchdown. Let's go. Shut up.
Yeah, I don't know. I just couldn't really get into it.
Yeah, honestly, there's different games that I like getting into or whatever. Especially over this like quarantine has been a little more able to. But honestly, you know, since getting back to work and stuff like that.
Yeah. You think shit's gonna shut down again?
They're talking about it. That's what I heard.
Because numbers are kind of getting crazy again, man. Mm-hmm. What the fuck do you think's gonna happen?
Everybody getting tested more.
Right. I don't know, man. I don't even.
He said, "I don't want to talk about it." Yeah, I'm good on it.
Yeah. Anyway, man, got the beanies coming Saturday. Just to start small, man. Samples. We'll have to go. You got to log into the thing so you can check it out. So you can.
Oh, I'm pulling the
designs and shit.
I'm pulling it up right
now. No, but I what I wanted to talk about too was fucking I wrote it down, the just like how black people are like portrayed in movies and shit.
Yeah, and I
guess just like who's in the wrong, you know? Cuz we got what do we got? Oh shit. Al, you want to hop on? Yeah. We'll stop and just keep pumping them out like fucking hotcakes, man. Keep scrolling.